Hi, I'm Andrew, the founder of AeroGrow. So first, I'd like to thank you for your purchase of the 4-in-1 meter set from AeroGrow. It's a fantastic little meter set and it's very easy to use, but if this is your first time using a pH meter or a TDS meter, you may be unfamiliar with just how it works. So today I'd like to go over just a few tips and tricks on getting started with your meter, using your meter, and caring for your meter. Let's get started. To take a reading with your new pH meter, begin by removing the cap and then single-clicking the on-off button. Now, notice how there's a bit of drift to the numbers. This drifting is completely normal behavior for these types of meters. Okay? Also notice how the bottom portion of the meter, the part that's covered with the cap, is the portion that you'll be dipping into the solution. That's the waterproof portion of the meter. The top portion of the meter, this part up here, is not waterproof, so please do not dip that in the water. Just the bottom portion that's covered by the cap, okay? Now to take a reading, simply dip it into the solution and you wait for about 4 or 5 seconds. And then you take your reading, it's as simple as that. Remember, there will continue to be a bit of drift, that's normal, but after 4 or 5 seconds, take your reading, you're done. The other half of your meter set contains the TDS EC temp meter. This meter will measure total dissolved solids, electrical conductivity, or temperature. Begin the same way by first removing the cap, turning it on, single-clicking the on-off button. Now, you'll notice that when we first begin, we are in TDS mode, which is measured by parts per million, as you can see on the bottom right. If we were to click this mode button again, we would now be in EC mode, which is measured in microsiemens per centimeter. Click that mode button again. We are in temperature mode measured in Celsius. Click it again. We're in temperature mode measuring Fahrenheit. And one more time brings us back to TDS measured in parts per million. So now, when we want to take a reading, we'll simply dip it into the solution as usual. Wait for 4 or 5 seconds. There you go. 24 parts per million is what this water measures. Now to clear that display, that's where we use the clear button. Clear. And it has now been recalibrated back to the 0 parts per million. Now, let's say we want to measure the electrical conductivity measured in microsiemens per centimeter. We'll put it in that mode and then we'll dip it in. A couple of seconds later, 48. Okay, 48 microsiemens per centimeter is our reading for that sample. Now to clear that, press the clear button, you're good to go. Now let's say, just because we're here, let's put it into temperature mode, Fahrenheit, because we're in America. Dip it into the water, 79.8. That's already reading 79.8, good to go. So, just make sure you rinse it in distilled water every single time, and then replace the cap. Push and hold the on-off button to turn off the meter. You're done. Replacing the batteries in your meter is also quite easy. Simply flip the meter over and you'll notice that there's a small indent on the back. Grab the meter firmly with one hand and using your thumbnail, pry out the battery compartment. The battery compartment contains 2 LR44 batteries. So then, using a small tool like a screwdriver, simply pry the batteries out. Carefully. And you'll notice that they go in one direction. So simply replace the batteries, observing the direction, and then place the whole unit back into the meter. There you go. Now, if it doesn't work when you place it back in, what you've done is you've put in the battery compartment backwards, like this. See, it won't work. If that happens, simply turn it over, remove it, flip over the battery compartment and place it back in the meter and everything should be fine. That's it. So hopefully this short video has been enough to get you up and running with your new meter set. But should you have any trouble with your meters or with the calibration or anything else, please don't hesitate to reach out to us through the contact page on the AeroGrow website. We even include our phone number so you can reach out and say hello. So until we see you next time, thank you for watching this video and thank you for choosing AeroGrow.